Tell you what, you do learn pretty quickly that these walks are really good for you. So after the terrible mistake I made with my walk up Rosebery Topping, where I got halfway up and I really thought I was not going to get back down again, and that was because I hadn't eaten anything before I set off. I normally nip in and have a McDonald's breakfast on my way to wherever I'm doing my walk. It just gets me, I'm not saying it's the healthiest thing in the world, but it gets me started. It means I'm not doing the stupid thing of walking on a healthy stomach and having my body, you know, burn food energy that isn't there, which is what happened when I walked up Rosebery Top. So the reason I know this is doing me the world of good is I only had that breakfast about an hour and a half ago. I'm getting hungry again. I assume that's because it's burning things away. But yeah, when it comes to exercise, it is a form of exercise I can live with. So as I've stated, this route is taking me to High Force, which, as you can imagine from the name, is the bigger version of the waterfalls here, of which we've already seen Low Force back there. Now, I have been to High Force, can't remember exactly when. It's a school trip of some sort, so I have vague memories of it, but it's hard to sort of shape into actual solid memories. Now, obviously, just to put expectations or set expectations, this ain't going to be Niagara Falls. But it is apparently one of the most spectacular waterfalls in the UK. So it's about as pretty much as impressive as it's going to get in this fair country of mine, so should be pretty spectacular. Now I'm coming up on a bridge. I have a feeling if I go right and walk over the bridge, that is me sort of looping back or following one of the many routes back to the visitor centre as an option. So I'm guessing if I continue on, that takes me to High Force, and then I'll have to backtrack that route to this bridge again to decide how I'm going to get back to the visitor centre. So let's see, when we're given that choice, if my general sense of navigation is helping me or letting me down. So yeah, if I go over that bridge and turn left, I'm heading towards the High Force Hotel, which is part of the route back. I have to walk near it or through it or something. We'll deal with that when I'm doing that section. Continuing on gets me to High Force. So the section of the route I'm literally walking now, give me a second, it's icy, I will have to walk back over. I don't particularly like backtracking, but I don't have any option in this case, so I think I'm pretty close. As you can see, I'm starting to head upwards. So hopefully that's a good thing. So I've come down along High Force, maybe somewhere here, and then back hotel, and I'm gonna come round somehow, so we'll see. I assume that white building is the hotel. As I say, I'll find out when I walk the other way. We've got snow on top of the Pennines there. So it's about now that I wish I had bought that dairy milk chocolate bar, so I would eat it now. So my walk along Hadrian's Wall, I bought a dairy milk chocolate bar. Not a really large one, but you know, bigger than the small ones. And I ate it halfway along and it really helped. But I thought, no, I'm trying to cut back on how much chocolate I eat. So I won't get one today. I regret it a bit now. I don't know how good or bad it is for me, but the sugar boost about right now would really be helping. So anyway, something to note for the future. Maybe just buy that dairy milk. Or if I wasn't so lazy, find some sort of more healthy alternative. But yeah, definitely eat that chocolate bar about now. So I can hear a waterfall. So I definitely think I'm getting closer. I'm quite looking forward to it now. Have a bit of a rest. But I'm really looking forward to it. There it is, that's pretty impressive. I think I can get further round and view it from a bit more to the top. There's also something at the bottom there, but I think that's a different route in, so I'll investigate that when I backtrack. But yeah, that's pretty impressive. So that's pretty impressive, well worth the walk. As I say, I don't know whether it's the highest in the UK or England or whatever, but it's definitely listed as one of the most spectacular, so well worth the visit. I'm going to walk back, see if I can, well, I'm going to consider walking towards the base of it, depending on how I feel when I get there. But yeah, this was worth the walk alone, just very spectacular. So I'm back at the bridge. Looks pretty great. I mean, the water behind me is particularly blue. You can see the reflections in it. Very nice. So I think now the order of the day is to walk to High Force Hotel, decide whether I want to do the walk to the base of High Force or loop back. Not sure at the minute. I really could have done with that high energy, well, more high sugar maybe, dairy milk, but see what happens when I get to the hotel. But yeah, this bridge is pretty spectacular. So, in the summer, when the grass is dry, you've brought some blankets, maybe some food. That's the place to sit, right? That is absolutely glorious down there, just near that bridge. I'd have had a sit there for a bit, but the grass is quite damp, as you can imagine, with it being frosty overnight. But yeah. Yeah, little camp. Little picnic, little paddle in the water for those who were brave. That was an amazing spot. I am not physically in the mood for those steps. But I don't like backtracking either, so I'm going to pause and then get up those steps. Yeah, wasn't expecting that. I guess the hotel's at the top of there. But it's really nice down here. And a nice place to sit by the river and stuff in the summer. Yeah, it's just nice. But yeah, I will mentally prepare for those steps. So yeah, I've decided to do the walk to the base. I'm quite looking forward to it now. Okay, as you can see, I've been to the bottom of the falls, very impressive. I've also been in the High Force Hotel, which is very nice. I can't remember all the menu items, but my bacon and sausage butty was very impressive. It was only £2.75, so if that's indicative, just give me a thing. Come on, Daisy. If that's indicative of the rest of their menus, it may be worth stopping there for longer and actually having a meal. But I wasn't up for that today, so I didn't do that. But their bacon and sausage butty was really nice. It was also dog friendly, so I could take Daisy in, which made it easier. Now, this part of the route's going to be interesting because it's the sort of public footpath I don't like, where basically you just get the odd sign and then lots of farmers' fields. It's all too easy to start wandering off across the wrong field and, you know, the one with a bull in or private land, which they tend not to like. So there is a couple of people in front of me, so I'm just gonna follow them. So I'm hoping it is A, adequately signed, and B, doesn't have any stupid turnstiles or ways of getting over fences that aren't very dog friendly. So yeah, hopefully it won't be too stressful. Yeah, didn't take long, and I've entered into no idea if I'm going the right way territory. So basically what happens is the footpath signs stop, the signs to any particular location stop, the map is obviously, no, keep going, Daisy. The map is obviously quite general, so it's hard to precisely map yourself on it. So at times like this, you just go for it, and hope you don't set yourself up for a half mile or so backtrack. I'm crossing my fingers. That is one impressive valley or whatever it is in the side of that hill. It's amazing. I wonder what formed that. No doubt there's a piece of information on that somewhere that would tell me. But okay, I'm keeping going, but I have a bit of a feeling I'm at the risk of having to backtrack which will really annoy me. Dirt pit. That's where I was headed. So I'm on the right track so far. My internal navigation didn't let me down, even though signposts and the map sort of did. So I'm assuming I have to go down here. As I say, always makes me slightly nervous when it looks like someone's farm. But let's see what happens. I'm sure if I'm going the wrong way, someone will politely tell me. So the farmer helped me out. So there was basically a path through their farm, and now I'm on this path, and this path stroke, almost a road in country terms, takes me all the way back to the visitor centre. So it should be quite simple from now on, because this is pretty much a road. But yeah, the scenery is still pretty cool. Is the road we're following. Over a stream. That is beautiful. So yeah, I should be on a steady, easy to follow path back now. Another public footpath annoyance when it goes through farmland is when the farm has a cattle thing on the road to stop the cattle just wandering out. So that tends to mean they sometimes don't keep their gate in order, because of course they don't need to lock the gate to stop the cattle and sheep getting out of the field. But what that means is a dog can't walk across the cattle grid either. So as I've just experienced there, I had to really manhandle a heavy and stiff gate, which I didn't think I was going to get open, and it was just way more hassle than it was worth, because of course I could have probably hopped across the cattle grid, but Daisy can't. So that's something that's really annoying, where the farmer just lets their gate go to shit because they've got a cattle grid. Anyway, we navigated it and we're still trucking. It's quite interesting seeing the snow up here. A lot of it's melting, I think, but yeah, it was a lot more frosty when... Sorry, swapping hands. It's a lot more frosty when I first arrived. It's all disappeared now. One thing I might recommend is actually that you do this route in reverse order. So okay, I'm not at the end of it yet, so I may change my mind. But if you were to do it in reverse order, everything would be downhill. And also you'd hit all the great stuff like the waterfalls in the second half of the walk rather than the first. So that means you've got less uphill travel. It also means you hit all the great stuff in the second half, so you feel like you finished on a high. This walk's been great, and the scenery I'm looking at now is pretty fantastic, but compared to the waterfalls, obviously it's a bit of a come down. So just give me a second. It's a bit of a come down, so maybe in terms of pacing the excitement, you're best seeing those in the second half. So yeah, maybe do it the other way around. So yeah, scenery. So there's a case in point. Cattle grid. Daisy can't get across that cattle grid. Gate. Well, at least that gate looks more like it's in working order than the previous one. But a perfect example. Don't like cattle grids. As cattle grids go, that's like something off some scary horror film. I mean, hell, I'm not even sure a human being would want to reliably walk across that cattle grid. Anyway, the gate was fine. So I'm coming up on a white building. I don't think it's the visitor centre, so I still think we've got a while to go. I have a feeling by the time we finish this walk, it should be about 3 to 4 miles. I've not had map my walk on, forgot again. But pretty sure it'll be about 4 miles, which isn't bad. But yeah, I definitely think it might be an easier walk and a slow build in terms of the excitement if you do it the other way around. So, see that building in the distance at the end of the path? It's got chapel-like windows. So I think that is the visitor centre. So if that's the visitor centre, we're back. So, a bit like the walk along Hadrian's Wall, the way back was just slightly more hazardous than the way there. So basically all of the firm ice has obviously melted. So we had a bit of a muddy experience coming back, a bit like Hadrian's Wall. So, but yeah, well worth it. So based on the full experience, I would say, should anyone watching this be doing it, I would say go the opposite way so that you do the section I'm doing now first, then the hotel, then the high forces and the low force, and back to the visitor centre. That way it's a slow build to the best stuff, and also everything is downhill. You don't have any steep steps to walk or anything, so it's much more pleasant. I mean, it's not really strenuous or anything, but if you want the less strenuous way, it's definitely best to do it the other way around. So that's it. The third Saturday walkabout, or the fourth if you include the one along the beach. So I will post in the description the walk up Rosebery Toppen. I'll also post the walk along Hadrian's Wall. And obviously you now have this one, which is a walk past low force and high force and then back around to the visitor centre. It's basically the River Tees, further westward in the Pennines. It's the same river that comes out at the south end of the beach I live nearby. And yeah, it was interesting seeing it from a different perspective, so I hope you enjoyed it. The usual thing, watch, like and subscribe. It tells me what people are liking and also knows people are watching, and hopefully get a community going that you can get some comments going and things like that. So yeah, watch, like, subscribe. Other than that, till next time.